So we shall start with summer air conditioning system with ventilation air bypass factor X. In the case when the bypass factor of the cooling and dehumidifying apparatus is not zero, it is evident from the figure it is given over here. We can see the figure. This is your DVT line. This is your specific humidity line. That if the surface temperature is TS equal to room temperature ATP, apparatus dew point, the leaving air state 2 will not be at S. It will be on the line joining 1S. It will be the line joining 1S. 1S line is there, 1S. This is 1, this is S. 1S, okay? It is will be on the line joining. It will be on the line joining 1S. Hence, the supply air state will not lie on the room sensible heat factor line, which is essential to satisfy the room sensible and latent heat load requirement. In such a case, which usually occur in actual practice, it will be necessary to lower the application, sorry, apparatus dew point, that is the effective surface temperature of the air conditioning apparatus, as in figure 15.25, in such a way that the leaving air state 2 lies on room sensible heat factor line IS, and also the new surface temperature TS dot or coil ADP is such that the following condition for the bypass factor X is satisfied. See the bypass factor X that is given by T2 minus TS dash upon T1 minus TS dash. It can be given in the specific humidity form also. Omega 2 minus omega S divided by omega S minus omega dash S. That will be H2 minus HS dash divided by H1 minus HS dash. See the figure here. That is very clear that TS dash, that is ATP. This is your ATP DVT line. And here the condition is given 0.1, 0.2. S is your ADP per temperature. Then room sensible heat line, this one. And grand sensible heat factor line is this one. It will be seen that the effect of bypass factor is to lower the ADP of the surface and hence to decrease the coefficient of performance of the refrigerating machine. It is also seen that the position of the grand sensible heat factor line is changed. This is explained in greater detail in section this. The supply air temperature that is your TP, T sorry TS is now increased to leaving the temperature T2, T1, that was T1, supply air temperature TS is now increased to the leaving temperature T2. Further, the dehumidified rise now TI minus T2. The dehumidified air quantity may be calculated accordingly, which will be found to be more than that of a apparatus with a zero bypass factor. Now, the recirculated air quantity can then be calculated by difference of the dehumidified supply air and ventilation air quantities. Since ventilation air quantity is fixed according to the requirement, this leads to a variation in the recirculated air quantity. The greater the bypass factor, the more the recirculated air quantity. as result 0.1 after mixing shift closer towards point towards I point is here. This is your I point. So now let us have a one numerical on this. Let us solve one numerical on this. A building has the following calculated cooling load. RSH, room sensible heat gain, 310 kilowatt. Room latent heat gain, 100 kilowatt. The space is maintained at the following condition. Room DBT dry bulb temperature 25, room relative humidity 50%. Outdoor air is 28 degree centigrade and 50% RH, and 10% bypass by mass of the air supplied to the building is outdoor air. If the outside mass jo hai wo outdoor air ka mass diya hua. If the air supplied to the space is not to be at a temperature lower than 18 degree, find out. Now we have to find out what are the things which has to be find out. Find out first minimum amount of air supplied to space in meter cube per second. Second, volume flow rate of returned recirculated room air, exhaust air and outdoor air. Third, state and volume flow rate of air entering the cooling coil. Then fourth, capacity ADP, BPF bypass factor and SHF sensible heat factor of the cooling air coil. This we have to find out. Now, referring to the figure, sensible heat factor is 0.758. 0.758 figure, well, this figure, and from here we have to calculate the sensible heat factor. And sensible heat factor, it is given, room sensible heat diya hai aur room latent heat diya hua hai, dono ko add kar denge total heat niklega, and that is given 400. Divide karenge total heat se, sensible heat divided by total heat, then we get sensible heat factor 0.756. Draw room sensible heat line, it intersect T is equal to 18, vertical given supply air state point S, which is the same as coil leaving air state point 2 from the psychrometric chart. So H1 ki value humari direct milegi 50.5 kilojoule per kg DA per kg dry air. H2 is equal to HS is equal to 41.2 kilojoule per kg of dry air. DA means dry air. Then V1, that is the specific volume, 0.836 meter cube per kg dry air, and H0, that is 92.0 kilojoule per kg dry air. Now first, supply air quantity and volume flow rate minimum, that is MAS dot, okay, supply air, room total heat, H1, HI minus HS, humko dono value malum hai, HI bhi malum hai, aur HS ki value bhi malum hai humko, dono enthalpy humne nikala hai chart se, to room total heat kitna hai, 410 total heat ho gaya, HI minus HS, HI humne nikala hai, HS ye hai, HI ye hai, HI minus HS, and calculate karne pe aa raha 44.09 kg per second. Then it is asking qv dash, that is ma, that is m ms mas dash into v dash, and from there we can find out ma dash, already we have find out 44.09, and vs dash, that is also 0.836. So it is 36.86 meter cube per second. Now the B part, quantity and volume flow rate of the outdoor air exhaust air, that is MAG dot 0.1 or MAS dot 0.1 to 44.09, that we get 4.41 kg per second. Next, QVO dot, that is MA0 dot into V0 for 4.11 into 0.91, 4.01 meter cube per second. So quantity and volume flow rate of the returned air, that is MI dot is equal to MA S dot minus MA 0 dot, 44.09 minus 4.11, and we get 39.68 kg per second. Okay, then QV1 dot, that is MI dot VI, 39.68 into 0.86, that gives 34.05 meter cube per second. And similarly, hence V0 is equal to 0.9 and VI is equal to 0.86 meter cube per kg of dry air are the specific volume of outdoor and indoor air respectively. Now see part, state of the air entering cooling coil. Cooling coil mein jo air enter kar raha hai uska kya position hai. Then T1 is equal to 0.9 TI plus 0.1 T0 is equal to 0.9 into 25 plus 0.1 into 38. That will give you 26.3. Then T1 dash, that is 19.2 centigrade at 26.3 centigrade dBT on the line joining I2O. V1 niklega phir 0.865 from psychrometric chart, and H1 554.6 kilojoule per kg of dry air. Volume flow rate of the air entering the cooling coil, that can be given by QV1 is equal to MAS dash V1 plus is equal to 44.09 0.865 is equal to 38.14 meter cube per second. Then last part that we have to find out, capacity, ADP, bypass factor and sensible heat factor of the coil. So we will come on the last part. Referring capacity, on the last part, refrigerating capacity, refrigerating capacity of the coil, that is given by Q coil dash, that is grand total heat, that is MAS dot H1 minus H2. MAS dot hum pehle nikal chuke hain, aur 44.09 aur 54.6 minus 41.2, that gives you 591 kilowatt. Theek hai, phir pooch rahe hai, coil ADP is obtained by intersection of the line joining 1 to 2 with the 1 to 2 with the saturation curve. Thus, ab hum nikal rahe hain aapka coil ADP, that is given by bypass factor and sensible heat factor of the coil, and that is